The electronic retail group Dixons has beat expectations to post record revenues for the year to the end of April. ETX Capital's Neil Wilson is with me. Neil, morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
Despite the doom and gloom here, Neil, and post-Brexit nervousness, I suppose, there's been a strong showing here from them.
Absolutely. Dixons is growing revenues by 4%, and the profits are up 10%, headline profits before tax up 10%. So it's managing to continue to sell, you know, fridges, TVs, all these things, despite fears among some competitors that maybe there's a slowing down in the market, that there's consumer spending is coming off a bit, and impressively it's continuing to grow market share at the same time.
I suppose the consumer market's constantly evolving in the way people buy goods from phones to washing machines, and would appear on the face of it at least they're able to keep up with these changes.
I think that's right. I think the online, you know, the sort of Amazon kind of factor has been an issue for the likes of Dixons Carphone, but it seems to have found its feet there, and it's improving in that area. So it's very well placed to manage the sort of shift to online that we're seeing. And when you go on their website and so on, it's very well geared up for the sort of modern consumer. So I think it's adapted very, very well.
Why do you reckon they're able to keep a few steps ahead when other retailers are struggling?
Well, that is a good question. The breadth of their offer is impressive. They've got that sort of consumer electronics and home, you know, white goods sort of area pretty much sewn up. You see competitors like AOL World trying to creep in, but really not really doing an awful lot. So I think that helps. Having presence overseas is helping the profits. I mean, we're seeing the translation effect from sterling boosting profits from overseas, and I think they're also, if we look at the connected world services, that's the sort of managed services part of the business, and where that's heading, that offers sort of scope for future revenue growth, even if say people don't want to buy fridges as much as they used to. So it's got a good platform, I think.
Really good, Neil. Good to speak to you. Thanks for your insight there.
Okay, cheers, Andrew. Thanks.